PokerStars.com European Poker Tour. On this journey, all roads lead to the grand final in Monte Carlo. And this week, the high rollers stop off in Copenhagen, the land of fairy tales and happy endings. So they've all paid their buy-in, and now all we have to do is survive a day and a half of grueling poker and make it to the final eight. All three previous EPT event winners are here to see if they can pick up another big check, but the field is tougher than ever. Let me introduce you to America's $5 million man, Greg Raymer. He won the World Series last year, but the fossil man was soon on his way home.
Both the tournaments in the US and Europe are full of great players, and you can have a great time and learn a lot either side of the Atlantic.
Also on the menu, the Hull's finest devilfish, proving that history can repeat itself. The Spanish curse struck again. He went out on a pair of kings.
I mean, this keeps happening to me just lately. And he had 220 to 1 to get dealt to kings and 220 to 1 to get dealt to aces.
That's life. Some local flavour was provided by over 50 Scandinavians, including PokerStars.com Caribbean Adventure winner Gus Hansen. He was out before coffee was even served.
It's the first time I've actually played a big tournament here back home, so it was a lot of fun.
Not that much fun, though. So leg four of the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour from Copenhagen. Nearly 200 entrants came here looking for a share of nearly €500,000 and a coveted place in Monte Carlo at the grand final. So the final eight, John Duthie, I mean, this is where it all starts kicking off. Everything that's went before over the last 10.5 means nothing.
They've all played incredibly well to get here, and they were going to see them now.
Well, we got Bambos Xanthos of Greek descent, originally from England. He sent over 100,000 chips. He's in seat one. Get a lovely round of applause from a capacity audience here in Copenhagen. Now, we've seen his face before in Dublin, I believe. Julian Thu makes another final table, and so far, two English players out of two. In seat three, Dan Pedersen from Denmark. It's the first time we'll have properly seen him play poker here in the European Poker Tour. And he's quite healthy stacked as well there. A lot of even stacks out there. Noah Boken, under 100,000 from the Netherlands. One of the youngest players to reach a final table at the European Poker Tour. And the same can't be said for Alexander Cooper. Sorry, mate.
Mr. Alexander Cooper.
From Norway, 206,000 chips. And in seat six, Eric Kolas. Kolas by name, Kolas by nature, also from Norway. And it's time for a familiar face next. The winner, of course, in Dublin of the European Poker Tour, the Hendon Mob leader, Ram Viswani. And his lovely wife here to cheer him on. In seat eight then, 443,700 chips, Michael Westerlund from Sweden. He's our chip leader, but there's a long way to go. So John, let's play some cards. Eric Kolas has to be pointed out, 20 years old. Just slightly beaten Noah Boken in seat four as our youngest ever finalist here at the European Poker Tour.
They seem to be getting younger and younger.
That's what I say about the ladies.
You wish.
Older and older, actually. Right, let's see some cards. We've got a 10, 5, 8-handed, unplayable cards for Dan Pedersen. He folds them round. I'll be interested to see them feel each other out at these early stages and find out who's going to be playing loose and who's going to be playing tight, John.
Yeah, there's an ace king. Let's see how he plays it. Okay, so Alexander Cooper raises.
Let's see if anyone wants a bit of the action. Certainly not in 6-4 unsuited. And the on Eric Kolas folds that. Both Norwegian. It's only about 60 years between him, and he's going to hit a pair of queens, which obviously will go in favourite. And you don't want to see them in the hand of Ram Viswani. Already a winner in Dublin, as we said, and just an all-round great, consistent poker player.
I know, he's put in a big re-raise there, Ram.
Well, there's one of his queens. Hello.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see. Well, it doesn't matter. He's winning anyway. See what Alexander Cooper does.
I mean, Cooper's had a good hand early on here. He'd be expecting to do quite well in the Ace King, and he could be walking into a massive hand early on. He's got 206,000 chips at the moment. Ram Viswani slightly ahead of him stack-wise.
Hold it.
Alexander has announced.
He played them very aggressively, but he's going to get called because he waited for such a long time. Ram will know that he's got ace king. I mean, he's going to take the gamble. That's
Ram is going to call.
Swanee calls, and he's going to be absolutely loving this.
Ram shows two queens. First two queens against
we get two
ace
the highest
king.
Stacks
two queens
each
are
other.
In the lead
second and third
covers.
Place. All in. Of course, Ram Vaswani would stay in even if he loses because he'll still have 70,000 chips.
Flop is
Alexander
nine,
Cooper
nine, seven.
Against Ram Vaswani.
In the lead. Here's your turn card.
997's no good.
It's
the
a three
three's no good. It needs to be an ace or a king.
Alexander
there's no other draw for Cooper.
King. Queens in the lead. Here's
Vaswani
a
faces
it's
stone
a
and a happy
queens
face
are win.
Now. Even
and Ram Vaswani is going to win this match. Alexander Cooper is your eighth place finisher.
Mr. Cooper. One more region left. And that's one happy wife. Already then down to seven players at this final table. Goodbye to Alexander Cooper.
On the break.
Seven players after a quite remarkable start. Alexander Cooper, you got to remember, spent last night in his hotel room. He's came all the way, not that far from Norway to Denmark. He's came over, he's been sitting in third place, and he goes out first hand. Ram over 500,000 chips now, and you don't really want to give him a lead like that. Just actually, yeah.
He's gonna feel very comfortable, and who wouldn't? Here's a little Mikhail Westerlund. When he puts his glasses on, he always waits a minute and then looks around the table.
Beware of a man in glasses. Who said that, Sean? What famous person said that?
I don't know.
Me. Just said it. It's no one said it with any.
Okay, looks like he's bet about 5,000. Oh, just a call with it.
Fan boss not interested. Julian Thu certainly looking to better his position he got in Dublin not long ago in the European Poker Tour.
Okay.
Dead calls.
Is Dan Pedersen chewing a fake cigarette?
It looks like he's chewing something to do with smoke.
Noah's going to move all in here.
Yeah, too.
So Noah Boken all raised in on a pair of eights, and obviously he doesn't know what the other two players have, but a great call from him.
That's a great bet from him. I mean, he's played it very aggressively. He's a relatively short stack, Noah. He's an aggressive player, and now he's got these two players to get through. I doubt that either of them will call. Oops, there I go again, getting it wrong.
We'll soon find out. I mean, people talk, is this rise in poker's popularity a passing fad? Well, you look at players like
he's
Noah Boken and Eric Colas, and that tells you it's
around $171,000 pot here.
And John, you were wrong indeed. Westerlund calls it.
Two eights.
It's a very strange call because what can he possibly be beating?
Maybe thinking that Boken was having him on,
Jack,
you know, maybe he was taking
nine,
him on. And that flop's
queen,
not really favourable to Westerland at all. I mean, we're not even looking
here's
straight draw.
Card.
He'd have to hit the turn on the river.
It's
and again, the three no
diamonds,
good. Boken leading with
no
the pocket
change.
Pair at the moment.
Here's your river.
And Westerland Stack's going to take a heavy hit unless...
It's a seven. Noah's going to win. And good luck to 170,000.
He's sitting very short stack. Last at this final table. And now with seven players left, he's doubled up. He's sitting pretty. So here's the basics of poker. Each player gets two cards each. They're your own. Then a round of betting based on the blinds amount. And then we get the flop. That's our first three cards in the middle out of five. Are you liking that? Are you not? Well, we're going to have another round of betting at this stage. Two players left and we get the turn card. Does that change anything? In this case, the Queen of Hearts. More betting than the final card, the river. You do not want to get beaten on this one. One more round of betting, then the best five card hand you can make, given the two in your hand and the five in the middle. In this case, it's a straight, which beats three of a kind. Let's get back to the table. So we've seen quite a lot of action early on here in Copenhagen, the fourth leg of the European Poker Tour. Monte Carlo looms now. Players are only getting a couple more chances to get those free seats at the big one.
Oh, glasses are on again.
Mikhail has opened this pot for 19,000.
Vesman, ace-2 again. He obviously hasn't learned from his hand against Boken, and he has a crack at that.
No, he's raised it 19 up to 19,000.
Jack nine suited.
Dan likes the look of that. Dan Pedersen.
Dan is caught.
course, the only Danish player left at the table, so he's a big favourite here with the crowd, except for with Ram Faswani's wife, I hope. Worst hand in poker, John, 7-2.
Horrible.
Eric Colas Folzak, just 20 years old. Would love to see him.
$55,000 in the centre, we're going to see the flop.
So two players, Pedersen against Vesterlin. No love loss, of course, here. Let's
flop
not forget.
Seven, five,
Denmark,
three,
Sweden, we're talking.
Two spades.
And the flop comes 7-5-3. Westerlin still leading with the ace.
Yeah, still leading. He's still well in front. There's only two spades there. He's got a middle pin straight draw here, so he's betted out.
It's a lot of thought process going. Either that or he's just thinking about having a fag. Westerlin raises, very aggressive. Foolish or aggressive?
I'm ordering.
Oh, wow.
Dan has moved all in.
Pedersen has called all in with a jack nine and hopefully looking to bluff Westerlin off the hand, bully him off the hand.
I think it's a really dangerous move. I mean, it's only he's raised, he's better, his whole stack, which is about 57,000, but Westerlin's already put in.
Now he's called.
It's a crazy suicidal move that against a player
so
like Westerlin. He's got too many chips.
Suited and close,
and
two over cards to the board against ace deuce off
so
suit.
The guy was obviously going to call.
Here is your turn card.
What can he hit?
Well, a bit of an experience here.
An
the
aces
come out for a
Westerlin.
Word of warning, he might have made the high pair, but Pedersen's got
today.
A club. So
here
Pedersen's
is the
looking
river.
One more club to save him. He's going to hit about one
it's
and five.
It's a five of hearts.
And he doesn't
aces
hit
and fives are going to win. And Ken is going to be our seventh place finisher. Macau wins 180,000 in that pot.
That's what it was. But he can smoke as much as he wants now, because he's just been smoked by Mikael Westerlin.
Considering you actually on the waiting list when you came here today, it's not all bad, is it? It must have been worth coming because you made it to the final table.
I expected more for today, and so I feel very bad now, but I get very... No hands, all day.
Thank you very much to Zsa Zsa Gabor. We're down to six players. Someone will need just begun. More poker after the break. Again, and it's between six top players. Well, whoever wins is going to have to hit some good hands. Here's how they work. This is the best hand. 10 to ace, suited and running. Below that, the straight flush. Again, suited and running. Doesn't have to be 10 to ace and four of a kind. The numbers match four times. Below that is the full house. Three of one, two of the other, and the flush. All the same suit. The numbers don't have to run. This is more likely you see a lot of these straights running five cards and below that three of a kind. To be anything from twos to aces and two pair is exactly what it says. We're getting down to the not so good hands. One pair won't win too many hands today. And the high card, hopefully you'll fold it. So as I say, six players left and sitting at the top we have Mikael Westerlin from Sweden with Ram Faswani chasing hot as he is over half a million chips. Noah Boken, well he's doubled up, he's in third place, still away off the pace. So an eventful start here in Copenhagen at the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour, and it's already building a massive reputation by the players. We've had a man called Greg Raymer who won $5 million come all the way to Copenhagen, and he's already caught an early playing home. Well, Faswani hits ace-king here, back from the break, pair of eights then. In the hand of our current chip leader, Mikael Westerlin.
This is going to be an interesting hand. You've got the Swami with ace-king, and he's got his glasses on again, and he's thinking.
Well, we've seen earlier, of course, the Swami sitting with the pair of queens and taking a player out, of course, Alexander Cooper, who is ace-king. Could it happen this way around this time? Well, let's see if there is only going to be two players. Queen-9 surely has got to be passed back to the dealer.
Yeah, they're going to want to be very careful of each other, Faswani and Westerlin, because they've both got very big stacks.
I mean, almost two-thirds of the chips between them. They could sit back here, they could... Well, they can't have a fag, we've learned that. You can't smoke at this table. But they could sit back, you know?
Well, they could, but they won't. It's not in their nature, either of their natures. They'll probably try to take the others out.
Read a magazine.
Two players are going to see this flop. 68,000 in the centre.
Okay, so 68,000 in the centre of the pot.
Not much for both these players, of course. Over a half a million chips each. We'll see if the flop changes that well. Vaswani has hit his ace. That puts him in the lead.
Ram first down.
Veselindo might have Vaswani on the ace. We'll see. Will it cost him much?
Well, Ram Vaswami checks, which is...
That's protocol. He's going to check that. He's not going to bet the top pair straight away. He's probably got Vesterlund on a pair. Even if he had the ace at Vesterlund, then Vaswani's got this king kicker.
Yeah.
Mikhail's bet 30,000.
Okay, so Mikhail's bet 30,000. Let's see what Ram does.
Will he play it hard or will he just call?
No. Ram has called. We're going to see a turn
calling.
Card.
He knows he fancies he's winning, so he's just calling.
128,000 in the center.
Setting up a bigger bet on the
three of spades.
Now, he could be worried in the spades at the moment. As it sets, of course, he's got that king in his hand. He's got the four spades.
Yeah, it's a horrible card. You know, it's made a straight and it's made a flush. You know, if Westland had 6-7, it's made him a straight. If he'd had two spades, it's made him a flush.
Of course, the two gives him the straight as well. So a lot of cards Vaswani has to be careful of. And Westland will know that and he might bet it.
Let's see how much he bets. Okay, so he's bet what looks about 80,000.
And Vaswani, through his head at the moment, he'd be running different calculations. He'd be worried about the flush, he'd be worried about the straight.
He's also worried about his chips too. You know, this guy's a chip leader, as you know, and Ram doesn't want to come up against him really.
He's called all in. So there you go, Johnny. It was one decision or the other. He's called it. Vesterlund, sitting chip leader, surely he's not going to call this.
I'll tell you, that is a hell of a bet. I mean, Ram's got he's got a very strong hand. He's got the top pair with the nut flush draw. So he's strong, but how does he know that this guy hasn't got the 6-7? How does he know that he hasn't already got the flush? He must have been playing with him, you know, for the last couple of days and spotted something. He knows it for sure.
Vaswani's mind's like a calculator. It really is. Of all the players so far in the European Poker Tour, I have to say personally, he's impressed me no end. And he can have even the top players in the world floundering and sweating and their hearts racing when he plays against them. And Vaswani goes all in, goes up against the chip leader. Both of them could have sat back in a
Cal lays this down, and Ram is going to win a pot of 290,000.
That puts him in chip lead at the moment. And what a fantastic play by Vaswani.
What a great bet. Great bet.
Ram Vaswani is now our chip leader. Players in the world coming to play this, and Vaswani is certainly one of them. So that's what makes him tick. Let's find out more about Vesterlund.
My name is Michael Vesterlund, and I'm from Sweden. Oh, I started to play poker like 21 years ago. Oh, you know, I play poker like it's 90% psychology, 10% the cards. You play against the player, and you play with the stacks. I'm a very, 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 very aggressive player. When I wake up in the morning, I start thinking about where is the closest game.
Okay, that's called Addict. That's a bit more about Michael Vesterlund. We overcomplicated his name there. Me, Kyle, we've been calling him so far.
I got a bit Russian, I think.
Either way, he's doing a grand job so far. Let's see how this pans out. More cards being dealt. Noah Boken, one of the youngest players on the tour at the moment, gets Queen 4 suited. Not looking at. Playing a very tight, careful game, Noah, so far. You've got to be impressed by the way he's adapted. And Eric Colas, the youngest player at this table, not getting a card so far, really.
No, neither is Julian. Doesn't seem to be getting many cards either. Ram's called with 7-10.
And he just wants to be involved in pots. He's got the chips to do it. He's got 750,000 chips. He can afford to be in these hands.
Oh, and get the glasses.
Is this a good thing, fiddling away like this, Michael Vesterlund?
We're going to see this flop.
Fiddling away. Surely he's just offering telltale signs of what he's doing.
The flop is 7-10 king, two diamonds.
Ram's day. Ram's first day. Days. He's flopped the middle two pair.
And that's hard to call, isn't it? It's very hard for anyone to call that he's flopped his 10-7, you know?
Cal bet 16,000.
Okay, so Mikhail Westerlund has bet 16,000.
Call him Mikhail again.
Oh, there we go. Michael.
Thank you. As in Jackson.
Oh, hello.
Probably not the best example.
Here comes a raise.
Ram raises it, makes it 45,000.
He makes it 45,000.
As he should do, of course, sitting in the two powers, and hard for Westerlund to call that. Let's call him just Westerlund from now on, no Michael or Mikai. We're just getting Michelle that will be in the next part.
Michael's going to call.
Oh, he's called it. He's got. He thinks
see a turn
thinks
card
he
might
hit. He's calling to hit a second pair.
And of course, maybe he
turn
thinks
is
as
the
well.
Nine of diamonds.
Arthur Swanee's on
half.
The take. The diamond comes out now. Bear in mind, three diamonds on board, one in the hand, another one would give him the flush. Let's see if there's another twist to this hand. Vaswani checks. Vesselin's got to decide what to do.
It's the second time the horrible scare card's come off for Ram, because you've got the Jack Queen, he's made a straight. If he had two diamonds, he's made a diamond.
Cal
so
checks.
They're both
here's
a bit worried about this flop now. They've only got.
It's the five of clubs.
Well, they've all checked that we get the five of clubs. We know Vaswani's got the winning hand.
Yeah, but Ram Vaswani will also know now that he's got the winning hand because Mikhail checked. So what he'll do is he'll probably put, yeah, he's going to bet.
Ram bets 100,000.
And that's a strong bet, 100,000 into the pot.
Well, he's overbet it. It's a great bet because he's overbet it to make it look like a bluff, which means that Mikhail might get suckered into calling this with the second highest pair.
He's also sitting back in his seat, he's dropped the shoulders. He looks a guilty man for Swanee at the moment, and he knows exactly what he's doing. He's luring Westerlund into a bad call, and it looks like we're going to see exactly that. Let's find out. A critical moment here, of course, because the more chips for Swanee builds, the harder he'll be to peg back for any of these final other five players. Glasses on.
Now he's thinking the hand through now, and he's thinking, okay, he checked on the flop, he checked on the turn, and now he's bet on the river. Surely it's a bluff.
$100,000 the bet from Vaswani, already 210 in the pot. As John says, that's why he's here calling the action. Kale,
show me the winner for 311,000. Tens and sevens, two pair,
and of course,
tens and sevens for Ram.
Mikhail
taps
into
the
that
table,
great poker from
and Ram is going to win a
300,000. Another hand for the Hendon mob.
I tell you, you play hands like, you know. I mean, okay, he checked on the high blind with 10-3, but then he hit his middle pair. He's got to think that Ram's got something.
Yeah, he absolutely maximised the most amount of chips he could have won from the flop onwards. He hit his two pair and he got as much as he would have got at any player. And anyone playing against him, no matter who it was in this world, would have bet that. So onwards and upwards.
I think you'll find that Ram probably thought he had a king. Okay, let's see what happens in this hand. So Julian Thew and Noah Boken both fold, as does Eric Kolas. Ram seems to have picked up a nice hand.
Just American Airlines there for him, so obviously he'd be disappointed
Ram
with that. Oh, you gotta feel sorry for this man. Michael Westerlund, sitting in the ace jack, has gotta consider a raise.
Yeah, well, he'll probably raise with his hand. I mean, Ram just called the big blind.
Well, he's gonna walk into the bullets. If he does make that raise, he's gonna walk into the bullets.
Definitely considering something that looks like about 44,000.
Great.
Mikhail calls the 4,000 and raises 30 more.
34,000
for Westerlund. King 2 suited gets folded. And a lot of players will not want part of Swanee's action here. Is of course sitting in the bullets. So will he raise it? Will he call it? He's going to call it, John, isn't he?
Ram call.
He's just trapping him. It's a very strong. You know, sometimes people play aces.
Flop is
like
three,
this.
Three,
this is a perfect
eight.
Flop for a pair of aces.
Account first to act.
You'll imagine Vesla made the race on high cards. That's why John says the perfect flop. We will not put him in threes or eights. And that's a great stat. Vestlin, 1% chance of hitting this hand at the moment. Let's see how Vaswani plays it. Can he trap him again? Can he maximise his chip count? And you've got to feel sorry for the Swedish man, because he's just walking into great hand after great hand from Vaswani. And OK, he's getting the cards,
but
he's
also
playing it well.
Oh, that's the way he's playing them. I mean, he's just flat called. He's OK, this is...
Oh, that's 100,000.
100,000 bluff. With overcards.
Vaswani, will he look to play this hard? Oh, he's called all in. Vaswani's gone all in.
Vesterlin
surely can't. He's called it!
That's
$212,000 bet for both
sure
players.
Sure, he's reading it the other way as well. Vaswani, of course, called his raise pre-flop.
So
he's not putting Vaswani on a three or an eight either. He might think his ace
they
is
shake
going
hands
to,
and let's see what the hands are.
Hand.
Two aces for Ram, aces and threes.
Vaswani's the one player that Westland should have been avoiding.
And he's went head on with
it. It's a four.
Well, the four
and the aces and threes are
no
going to win this pot.
Ram's drawn dead now, of course.
And another big pot. Mikel is our fifth, sixth place finisher.
Who was chipped
sixth place finisher in Mikel.
7 minutes ago, says good night. John, sum up that hand in one word.
Extraordinary.
Yeah, I don't feel lucky. That's for sure, but... I come in a bad streak and I lost, I think, the four or five last pots. I was in all of them and I lost them all. I think I had a really bad luck, but I probably could have played it better as well. So.
Who's going to walk away with the trophy tonight?
Ram will win this, no question about it. He's a great player, he's in a good streak. I don't think they will stand a chance, actually.
So Westerlund's gone west. More European poker tour after the break. Welcome back to the European poker tour in Copenhagen. Let's get a look at where we stand so far in a massive chip lead then. Over a million chips for Ram Vaswani. Noble Ken leads the chasing pack. Julian Thu, another final table, but he'll need some action. And we've heard little from Danthos so far. Kolas brings up the rear. Five players left. Money off for grabs, of course. You can just see the devil fish sitting in the background with one Ram Vaswani's wife. Hope there's nothing untoward going on there. And we're looking at Eric Kolas then. As we said, the youngest player at this table, 20 years old, takes a look at a Queen 10. He cites his interest as playing poker and watching SpongeBob.
Eric has moved all in here.
He goes all in on his Queen 10. That's not very nice. Kolas, I'd love to see him win this, but he'll need some action at this moment.
I think those are the best cards he's had since the beginning of the final table.
And Vaswani, of course, strong place. Vaswani folded the ace, and not much we're seeing so far. Let's have a look at Noel Borkens cards. He's got an ace nine, similar hand to Vaswani.
Noel's going to call.
And he calls it.
150,000 in the pot. Noel shows ace nine offsuit against Queen 10 offsuit.
They both need chips. Let's see what the flop brings. An ace would be good for Borkens.
King, deuce,
it hasn't came out. Of course, he leads though with the ace at the moment. The
ace is in the lead. And still
queen
covers.
Queen 10 for Kolas.
Here is the turn card. It's a queen.
And it's a queen. Kolas has hit his card.
The
20-year-old now hot
Eric
favorite
has made
for this.
Queens.
Borkens needs
it's
a speed,
ace.
Or he needs
it's
an ace,
on the end, and Noah's going to win.
Borkens takes it wherever. We say goodbye to the 20-year-old Eric Kolas from Norway.
Noah
he's
wins
got a
175,000 in this
last time you see him at a final table. Well done, son.
And now four players remain for the Scandinavian Championship.
Well, let's take a look at this hand chronologically. Before the flop, Borkens' favourite. After the flop, he's still there. But look, the queen comes in the turn. Kolas fills his two pair. Only an ace will save Noah. Hallelujah. It helps having a name from the Bible. He hits his aces and twos.
Rumour has it you want to become a full-time poker player. Do you think you're ready to join the big boys like that?
Yeah, that sounds good. I can live with this.
Okay. And you qualified with your brother, actually, didn't you, on PokerStars to get here today?
Yes, we play the same satellite, $380 satellite, and we both want a seat.
And how do you feel about people saying that you could be becoming the David Beckham of poker?
Well, that's a bit exaggerated, but I'll try.
You try, but you think Ram's going to walk away with it tonight?
Yes, no doubt.
Well, you seem pretty calm compared to most of the poker players who walk out.
You think? I'm nervous like hell.
Will he not be short of a few ladies, I'm sure, tonight round about Copenhagen? Good karaoke bar on Main Street we went to, John. Oh, sorry, is the wife listening? Sorry about that. Let's take a look. King 4 then gets folded as well. And we go round to Julian Thu. Let's look at his cards. He's got 8-10. Not great cards dealt. Let's see if he's going to play.
He's probably playing because he's bored.
Julian's called here.
Of course, on the small blind. Tam, Pedersen.
No checks.
Is gone. Seat three, seat four is Noah Boquen. A lot of action early on here at this final table. See what twists we have, and as the flop deuce, comes out. King, eight comes out, so two fills a pair.
Yeah. Head is always checked.
And he checks.
No checks. Turn
maybe worried about the king at this stage.
It's the ten of diamonds.
And the 10 comes out, so he hits his 2-pair now. And we've seen a hand like this earlier in tonight's programme, of course, for Swanee hitting 2-pair.
Yeah, you see how Julian plays it differently. He overbets, trying to pretend a bluff too, but I think I'd have probably checked to Noah here, because Noah's more likely to have bet when that came out, even though he hasn't got anything.
So he makes a boisterous bet. He's going to take the hand, no doubt, but maybe not extracting as much chips as he could out of Noah.
Noah lays it down. Julian,
and that's been
borne
out. He folds a hand. Some chips go to Julian Fee. He'll like that anyway.
He'll like it, but he could have got more.
I'm Julian Thew from Nottingham in England. I'm not a professional. I still work part-time, and I mainly play at my local £20 competitions in Nottingham, which is, you can get some good practice in there. There's so much information out there on the internet and books, and if you play regularly, you learn something every time you play. I don't know if I'm a quick learner. It's like I say, 5 or 6 years, I'm not an overnight sensation. I mean, you have to be prepared to put it on the line sometimes. You can't just sit there and, you know, wait for good hands. Yeah, I've picked up a sponsor since Dublin, Lucky Boy.
So we're finding out more and more about these players as the European Poker Tour continues.
Oh my God, what's that?
How dare you say that about Faswani's wife? Oh, sorry, Devilfish trying to get you now. So, I mean, Ram Faswani's on fire this year. 2005 has been a very big year for the man himself. He's already won a European Poker Tour, and he's gone a long way to do this. Over 1 million chips sitting in front of him. And Julian Thew calls all in on an ace three offsuit. Not many players in front of him, though. He might quite fancy this. Let's have a look and see what Noah Boquen's got.
I think it's the first time that Julian's had any high card, an ace.
Noah's going to call.
Noah Boquen has called.
Julian shows ace three.
Of course, he's in a similar
situation.
He's not had great cards so far, so he's going to call it. We've seen what the cards are. No more betting.
It's likely to be a split pot, this, really.
Well, let's have a look and see how it pans out. Two kings come out with a four.
Ace five currently in the lead.
Needs to be a low card for not.
Oh my, and it is a low card,
they
of course.
Up a straight draw now.
Five will make
ace
a straight
five
for
is still
three.
The lead.
That's
awful. Boquen needs a three for a straight.
An eight.
The eight comes
and
out,
Julian's
and that's
gonna be
such
our
a low card, as you said, John.
No, it's going to be 190,000 in this
fight. Amongst the pigeons. Julian Thew says goodbye from another European Poker Tour final table.
Now, how do you feel when Ram's playing at the table and he's got so many chips? How hard is it for you to play?
I guess you're aware that he's probably going to look you up at some point, so it's always hard when someone's got that many chips, but because the rest of us have got so few, we have to get busy with something, so it's just a case of who gets unlucky first, really.
Is it an intimidating feeling at all?
No, not really. That's poker, you know.
So Thew is through, and as he said, it's about getting lucky. At this stage, Ram Faswani's chip lead is so high, as we can see. He's set with 920,000. Noah Boquen's climbing up, and he needs some more chips to be a challenger. And Babos, third place. Another hand here at the European Poker Tour. In Copenhagen, if you've just joined us, three players left. Xanthos, Greek descent from England, this table. Ram Faswani, another English player. Oh, and we got an all-in call
in
here from Bambos Xanthos. Great name. Queen nine he's got. Will he stay alive? If only for the name, I hope he does. We've had a fold from Boquen. He's going up against Faswani's eight king suited. He's got a decision to make here, John.
Yeah, I think he'll probably call because he wants to. He feels obliged, probably, Ram, to take out these players. He's got so many chips. He's only calling. He's calling a very small percentage of the stack. Yeah, he has, yeah.
And of course, this three handed, and it's worth noting this at home if you're an enthusiast new player to poker.
Against
king
8
three handed suited is quite a big hand.
King 8 is
in the lead and covers.
Yeah, it is.
Here's the flop.
It is a big hand, and as you can see, it may well win.
Well, Xanthos will be looking for the queen to come out, and he gets it straight away. He'll be thanking his lucky stars. Faswani hits his eight, the word of warning, the eights are there.
A pair of eights for Ram.
but this is good so far for Xanthos. The two is not going to help Vaswani. Xanthos and his queens keeps him alive at the moment. Vaswani just a 10% chance.
And the queens are going to win, and Bombers is going to double up here.
Bombos stays in and Ram sits back down. He's lost a few chips. It'll not get the stack too much. But Xanthos is back in the game.
My name is Bambos Xanthos. I come from Cyprus and I live in England. I've been playing poker since 1960. Actually, my father was a poker player, and I was watching him, and I learned how to play poker from him, really. All the competitions nowadays, they are aggressive. A lot of 20-year-olds and 25-year-olds, that the minute they see an ace in their hand, they think they got the crown jewels. So they go all in and play very tight. I don't feel a good player. I'm trying to be a good player.
So at the moment we're three-handed here at the European Poker Tour in Copenhagen, our fourth heat. Of course, we're heading towards that big final in Monte Carlo. Have you packed your Bermuda shorts yet, John?
No, but I'm looking forward to it.
Because you only have one suit, so
it's part for 40,000.
I'm going to get another one.
Another suit? And what they pay us? No Boken then. He hits the King Jack, very strong hand, three-handed. And he's going to walk into pocket tens here, and it's going to. He's got to be looking at an all in, and he is, of course he is. Bambos Xanthos from England. He's looking really to double up at least twice to stand a chance of going away with the top prize here today. And
raise of 161,500.
See how much it is. 161,000 more.
That's a lot for Boken to go on without an ace in his hand. Even with the King Jack, he'll have to think.
That was called here. We're going to see this. And it goes two tens against Jack King. Here's the flop.
You've got to gamble in this game.
And he's only a slight underdog. We're looking at a king or a jack to send Bambos home. We've seen the king
already. Noah has flopped a pair of kings.
So at this stage, we're really only looking at a 10 coming out to help Xanthos to hit his trip 10.
It's an ace.
The ace comes out. One more card for Bambos. Then it's Vamos.
Here's the river card.
And the river's an ace. That's kings and aces for Boken. He takes the pot. Aces and tens for Bambos.
400,000. And Xanthos is our third place winner, and we are going to pay heads up for the Scandinavian Championship.
Third in Copenhagen. As Boken counts his chips, let's look at his hand, John. Well, the pair in the hand, slight favourite, but after the flop, of course, Boken makes that pair of kings and he moves into the lead. The turn and the river gives him two pair each, kings and aces, but that beats tens and aces. Goodbye, Bambos.
I got pair of tens. At that stage, a pair of tens is a big hand, so I thought, this is my moment. I pushed it all in, and that was it.
You did a lot of nice little all-ins, didn't you? Can you remember how many all-ins you actually did throughout that?
No, I can't remember. But I remember watching somebody in Vegas, and all he kept doing is this business, and he kept winning, so I thought I'd try that.
I'm going to try that technique this time. Yeah. Well done for coming third place anyway. You survived very well. What was it like playing against Ram, you know, when you had that many chips?
Well, I played with Ram before, so I know, but he had too much chips for us to have any chance against him, really. And he's hitting cards as well.
Who do you think is going to take it away tonight, Noah or Ram?
I think Ram has got the edge.
For the fourth round of the European Poker Tour, and let me tell you, any break is too long a break. We see Ram Vaswani with nearly a million chips, plays against young pretender Noah Boken, heads up here. And of course, as you said, John, before the break, it's looking okay for Noah. If he gets the cards, he plays them well, he could still win this.
Well, he's still in quite a strong position. He's got 600,000 chips to Ram's 938,000, I think it was.
Rams open this pot for 45,000.
So it's a raise of 45,000, and what makes Vaswani such a hot favourite heads up is that he plays it as well as anyone in Europe. But Boken calls with a pocket fours, and as you'll see from a graphic, slight favourite, even over ace king. 54% in this, but really nothing in it whatsoever. But Boken still leading because pre-flop he had something, and Vaswani hasn't had his ace or his king. See how strong he plays this.
Rams checked. Here's your turn card.
both check the hand. The king comes out. Vaswani's hit the card he needs.
Noah's bet 20,000.
And Boa can bet. If Vaswani's going to look to raise here, John.
He's looking. He's eyeing him up now, trying to work out what he's got. Trying to work out whether he's just going to flat call or re-raise him.
Ram's going to raise. Made it 60,000.
Not a huge amount, though. He's obviously wants to maximise his... It depends on the river card here. He could hit a four.
That's interesting. It's an interesting call, though.
In the pot, here's your river card. It's the six of spades.
And it comes out as the six of spades. That doesn't help Boakin, so it's Vaswani's pot. But let's see how it turns out, because, of course, it's not just about the cards. Let's see how it's bet.
Ram's bet 100,000.
And surely he can't call this.
Well, it doesn't look like he can call, but if he came back over the top, it'd be quite difficult for Ram to call as well.
Noah calls.
And he just calls it flat. It's a naive call from the
Ram
younger
shows
player.
Shows kings with an ace, that's ace a, king. That's Ram is going to win a pot over 400,000.
He's only really beat a bluff.
Over 400,000 chips to be exact, and Ram Vaswani doesn't need any help.
I've got to admit, I'm a bit of a poker junkie. I've played online, I've had sessions for like 2 or 3 days non-stop. The wife's not too happy about it, so I'm taking it easy these days. I am an aggressive player. You've got to look at the other players on the table, their characters, their moods, and, you know, take every situation as it comes. It's the trophies I won, you know? I love winning, and it's another great chance to win today.
Well, you've heard it from the voice of the master, and his wife's probably not too happy sitting beside Devilfish as well. He won't have shut up the whole time in the crowd, John.
Oh, we've rabbited on for hours. He'll have told her what every player's got in his hand.
Exactly, I'm probably called most of it right. Vaswani's got an ace jack, and that's the thing. He's walking into some fantastic hands as well, so I'm the chip lead. And when Boakin hits a slightly weaker good hand, it could be curtains for the young man. Let's see what happens in this hand. Ace 8, he's obviously going to call that.
Flop is 3, 6, 7.
Boakin checks it.
Vaswani is in the lead.
Well, he is in the lead, and he does check it. And very rarely does he give a card away.
The 8 of hearts.
And he's given it away, and Boakin's now hit the top pair.
Ram has checked. Here's your river.
Checked again, and three cards all over the place. Boakin makes his two pair. Vaswani's going to like the ace. He could walk into something here, John.
Yeah, he's going to
bet. No, that's 40,000.
Shame that Ram's going to have to call this too, unfortunately, for him.
If he had have checked with ace coming out, Vaswani would have come in anyway. He probably would have made maybe even a bigger bet than the 40,000. See if he raises. He has done.
Ram says raise it. Mm. Made it 100,000. He's raised it 60,000 more.
Call. And Boakin just calls out with the two pair.
Shows ace jack.
And he'll take it, of course.
Surprised
he didn't raise.
Aces and eights, two pair.
Surprised no, Boakin
didn't
raise.
Pot.
Not really, you can't raise him. But
anyway, Noah Boakin takes that hand, and the Dutchman grows in confidence.
I started when I was 20, 4 years ago. It's just a great game to play, like, it's never the same. I play a lot online, PokerStars, some other sites, but I play a tournament once a week. I go out a lot with friends, hang around with friends a lot, and on my list is a gym, but I never get that far. I play pretty tight, but when I'm in, I'm pretty aggressive, and like most of the time I know what's going on the table. Like, I think I can read the people pretty well, just like the honor to win. You want to win, and the money comes second. Like, somebody just asked me how much you're winning, I don't even know. We'll find out later.
So a lot of money is at stake here in Copenhagen. That final in Monte Carlo is what every player in Europe is talking about at the moment. Pocket
Noah's
eights for Noah, and he's starting to get the cards as well. The go is his very shrewd play.
He looks very confident, very confident.
Vaswani with a jack two unsuited.
This would be a very strange call, but I can see that he's going to make it.
It's in his eyes, and he's going to do just that.
I know he's not even going to call.
Ah. Ram has called and raised.
A clever remove than even I thought.
Raised 115,000 more, to a total of 170,000.
And that's a massive raise, 115 on top of that. But this is heads up poker. He's going to play with Noel. He's going to try and get wee reads on him, see what he's going to call on. But of course, he's walking into pocket eights, which is immensely strong.
It's a massive hand heads up pocket eights.
And he's
going to go all in.
He's
went
back over the top and re-raised him. Noel Bulkin all in. Vaswani, of course, can't make that decision. And he's just thrown his chips away.
Noel's going to win 344,000 in that pot. 344,000.
Get more heavy against the less experienced player.
No, I think you're right. I think he tried a quick re-raise and unfortunately no, couldn't put his eights down and came back over the top.
€150,000 to the winner here, €75,000 to all intents and purposes to the second place. And more importantly, of course, it is all about getting to that final Monte Carlo. And as we said, Ram's there.
The blinds are still 10,000 and 20,000.
Noah has opened the pot for 55,000.
Noel Bulkin on the 8-5 unsuited raises that pot up, John, and he's playing very aggressively this hand.
Yeah, it's a creative raise. Heads up.
Ram has
just calls again. It's unusual play with an ace. You know, let's have a look and see what happens.
Flop is ace, four, jack, two spades.
Well, he gets his ace. Vaswani hits his ace, and he's going to like it even more now. But as I say, he seems to be checking everything right. He's given Noah Bulkin cards that sometimes he needs.
65,000 bet by Noah.
Well, Ram's trap checked him. He wanted him to bet that six. You know that. Well, not that amount specifically. He wanted him to bet, and he did.
65,000.
Ram has called.
It's a call from Vaswani.
245,000 in the center.
Let's take a look at the turn card.
Queen of diamonds.
Comes out queen. Vaswani miles ahead in this hand.
Ram check.
And in fact, at this stage, Bulkin drawn dead. Let's see if he bets it.
160,000.
Such a strong bet at this stage, John. And what will be going through for Swan?
Ram lays
mind.
It down and knows
down
going to win
the pot.
What almost a quarter of a million.
That's a hell of a lay down. I mean, he folded so quickly there. I think Ram must have put him on. He must have put him on two pair or an ace with a big kicker. I mean, how wrong he was.
Vaswani's looking at Bulkin slightly puzzled, as if he's just hasn't quite got a handle on him.
It's almost the thing is Ram's never really come across played both no heads up before. I think you're right. I think he's a bit confused. He doesn't really know how to play him.
And that looks good. Certainly, when there's €150,000, the top spot. Vaswani with Jack 5 suited against the worst hand in poker, 7-2 unsuited. Let's take a look at the flop. And he hits a 7, and
flop
that's
is 6,
now
a 7, queen,
here,
king,
doesn't need to
two
hit
diamonds.
The cards to win. We've seen him make Vaswani lay down winning hands. Bulkin checks, Vaswani makes the bet.
25,000, and Noah's going to call.
And Noah calls that with the bottom pair, 7s, which leads.
It's the 5 of diamonds.
Oops, now Ram's hit a pair too.
Noah has checked.
Vaswani. Bulkin checks, sevens, which is leading. They'll be worried about diamonds.
It's the 10 of hearts.
The queen. They'll be worried about the king.
Noah checks and Ram checks. Noah says he's got a 7.
And that
beats seven
for
is good
five,
for 100,000.
Sevens for Bulkin. He takes it out. Quite a small one in terms of what we've been watching.
It's kind of relentless, really, for Ram here. He's just losing pot after pot after pot, which is just not good news.
Well, it is for Noah Bulkin. He's a live wire. If he's not playing poker, like around the Hotel Scandinavia, he's out in the town enjoying a few beers and very much part of the new professional poker jet set, I suppose, John.
The new wave.
That's it.
Okay, so ace jack for Ram.
These guys, John, these young players, they don't watch Last of the Summer Wine like you. They're out busy partying. And Vaswani on ace jack.
Uh-oh. This is going to be difficult. This could be. Oh yeah.
All right, we've got both players all in here.
Ace
jack for Ram. Ace queen for Noah. Ace queen is in the lead, and Noah covers Ram.
And it could be all over. Vaswani could
be taking
second place. Bulkin. What a fairy tale story to come through from where possession was.
Flop is jack 10-3. Ram is flop top pair here.
Oh.
Jacks are in the lead.
It's not all over yet for Ram. That's, you know, this
turn
could,
card.
This could go on now a bit. You know, okay, there are.
It's a king. Yeah. Noah has made the nut straight, and Ram is drawing dead to a queen. Queen for a tie. Here's the river.
And we're going to be all over here in Copenhagen.
It's a five, and Noah Buchan has won the Casino Copenhagen Scandinavian Open Championship here in beautiful Copenhagen, Denmark. Noah Buchan makes the nut straight on the turn to win $1,560,000 in that pot. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a great hand for our second place finisher, Mr. Ram Viswanathan?
I think that they both played incredibly well. I think that Noah really outplayed Ram here, and Ram would be the first to admit it.
Well, Noah Buchan from Holland is heading to Monte Carlo for the final of the European Poker Tour, and with it, he left nearly €150,000. Ram Viswanathan, one less than he managed in Dublin, where he won €73,000 for him. Big money at stake.
Noah Buchan, congratulations.
Thank you.
You're obviously very, very happy.
Very happy.
What was going through your head in that last hand?
Give me a king. And it came. I was like, oh, when I saw the jack, I was disappointed, but I knew I still had some outs. And
well, you played superbly. You were 10-1 down, and you just came straight in at the end there.
Thank you, yeah.
And it's your first big live victory, am I?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Ram Viswanathan, last winner, but you come second place this time. And yeah, tell us about that last hand.
He had me down on chips anyway, so it's a question of finding a big ace and sticking them all in. But, he's one of the up-and-coming players in the game. He's going to win a lot more tournaments. Good luck to him.
Okay, I'm sure we'll see you in Deauville, Vienna, Monte Carlo.
You'll see me at all of them.
Well done, lads. Well done.
Champion Noah Buchan receives his check for over €1 million.
Money doesn't matter, but it does matter when you handed a check like that from Poker Stars. That's all from the European Poker Tour here in Copenhagen, certainly from John and I. It's a nice still younger bottle of wine, maybe a nice meal.
Well, maybe we'll get Noah to take us out for a drink.
I can afford it. Well, that's all from Copenhagen. We'll see you in Deauville next.